Here we are. It is Tuesday, July 3rd. I realize I haven't always been good about giving the date. And we're back. We're exactly where we left off. Except, we got, can't see it. Another big pile of 2x6s. And another big pile of 2x4s. And it has been raining almost nonstop since I quit. This is a mud pit. Eh. I should have dug out that trail before I got over anxious and started building. But whatever. I just have to be real careful coming up that last little bit. But yeah, it's super sticky muddy right now. But the agenda for today is... Oh, I have some shuffling to do with the framing that I've already built. I've got A's to build. I've got to put this last one together because it didn't get fastened together yesterday. So it's got to get cut on both ends of each rafter and then attached to each other. I have one more A with a short leg to build and a header. That will be the kitchen opening between the A's to build. Yeah, stuff to do. I'm not sure. I might build the kitchen wall too. I'm trying to figure out the best way to build things so it's not just a giant pain in the ass to put it all together. Because we have such a small work area and you just want to be able to pick it up when you need it. But also have room to build it. So, I don't know, it's kind of tricky. So, I've got those three A's. I have another partial A. But then I've got, of course, framing that needs to be inside the back wall. And framing for the kitchen that needs to be done. Anyway, figuring out how to do it so that I'm not, like, on top of myself with... having really just this platform to work within is kind of hard. I might have an idea. So I think I'm going to build these guys, the rest of the A's. But I think I have an idea. We'll see. One of the short-legged A might get attached to one of the full A's with a brace, a temporary brace, so that it's out of the way. Until the header goes in between the two full A's. Okay, I don't know if you're following me. So there's two A's that make up either side of the kitchen opening. There's one short-legged A in the center of that opening that meets with the header. But getting all of those things in place so that you actually have room for all of them and they all go up in the right order to hold each other up is a challenge. So I think if I put up two outside A's, I put the short-legged A attached to the brace to one side, and then I put the header on, then I could just move that short-legged A into place on that header, fasten it in place, and call it good. And then everything should be out of the way, and I can build the kitchen wall. Might be the plan. I've been stewing over this for days. Probably a week. Yeah, I think that's the plan. Okay. Gotta go get cutting. Oh, it's kind of drizzly, so the camera's not gonna be out much. We'll see what I can do. Three A's complete. A couple of 2x4s here. I'm gonna start bracing them so that when they're ready to tip them up and lean them up on the one that's already up there, that they will stay as an A. They'll keep themselves together. So I'm going to brace them. And then two of them need to get picked up. I can build the third short-legged A. And then the last A will get picked up and put out of the way. And then... I think we can actually start, once the third A is picked up, put together, we can start putting them where they are going to live. Well, A couple of them. We still have to keep enough open space in the room that I have an 8-foot span, which is that line there to this line here and to the center line. That area has to stay clear, at least that, so that I can build the kitchen wall and then stand that up. Once that stood up, we'll have a little bit more room available to put up the, you know, put things where they're going to live permanently. But I'm trying to make sure that I have enough room to build that wall and stand it up without it being a huge obstruction or, you know, just having to jury rig how I do it. So anyway, so I think I'm going to brace these. Livin's doing some work down at the cottage, so I'm not sure when he'll be available to come and tip these up. I don't want to interrupt what he's doing too much, but I can't tip them up by myself. So yeah, I'll brace these and then start on the next and final A. Look who's here! Here we go. Let's see how we do.
Yeah, so that old battery.
Oh, yeah. Totally. Oh, completely. Did you tell? You did that thing with the...
So I disconnected that one first, so the good battery was isolated. And that was that where I had like 12.4 volts. Not great, but not fine.
Yeah. So this will give me room. I can build. I have to build a short A, short leg A.
Right, and that goes dead in the middle,
Go dead middle.
Yeah.
So the order of these things isn't perfect because I should, in theory, I would put this one up here and sandwich this one to it. Right. My fear is that I'll end up with so many braces in the middle of the room.
Yeah, you won't be able to build.
I won't be able to build. Can you believe I actually thought maybe I'll lift these myself and started to? Wait, should we put it here and then the next guy? That's pretty cool, huh? You can't see the tops. Oh, the nail gun. There, let's see. All of them are up. I have a clear platform, so now I can work on the short A. I have 2 2x4s, which are the rest of the bottom plates. There, they go along this edge. Finish that out. I can build that short A. Start thinking about the kitchen. Yay! Progress. Pretty cool. The view from under all the peaks is fun. Okay, I've got one side of the A, the last short-legged A. One side, the long side is done and cut, but the short side, the batteries didn't make it. So the top edge is cut, but where it'll meet the header, I was only able to get a quarter of the way in, so no more battery life on the saw cutter, on the saw, and that's okay. It's been a full day. I'm pretty proud that all the A's are upright, except for this guy. Those are the hardest things. So tomorrow is the 4th of July. I don't think I'll be doing anything unless I do something in the morning, which maybe, I don't know, it depends on what we're in the mood for, because we're going to go down to the ocean for the fireworks in Hilo Bay and have a picnic. So yeah, we may end up just being there all day and hanging out in the water, which would be cool. Maybe see some more turtles. See? But the next thing after this guy, I think, so Wednesday was 4th of July. Thursday, we had nothing going on. Friday, oops, thought I could take my sunglasses off, but no. Friday, we're going up to Waimea for Lurvin's little staycation trip up there for his birthday. I'm pretty excited. But so yeah, Thursday probably I'll work. I have the wood to get started on that kitchen wall, which and the header where it meets the A. And so I'd love to start on that. That would make me happy. I'm so done with doing rafters. Because although there are only 5 rafters, it's 5 A's, it's 10 rafters, all built by myself, all with the cuts, having to figure it all out by myself, which I'm so used to Lurvin doing all the hard thinking. I'm so spoiled. at least in the cottage. He was very much the engineer on that structure. And so I just did what I was told. Now I have to think and plan and think and plan. So anyway, it's turned into a gorgeous day, as you can tell. Didn't start out that way. Yesterday, as you saw, it rained in the afternoon. And then it rained hard overnight, like made this place kind of swampy. So I wore this long sleeve shirt because I didn't feel like feeling all the rain on my skin all day long. Because if this shirt's good for helping you feel dry even when you're not. And I was joking with Thurvin that I put this long sleeve shirt on because he needed it to not rain while he was doing electrical work. And I, sure enough, brought the sun. Now I don't need to be wearing this shirt. It's gorgeous. So yeah, long beam done. Short beam not. So this A is almost to completion, but not quite there. I'm going to go and clean up and get myself a glass of lemonade and enjoy the sunshine a little. Okay, bye.